Hello and welcome to Maths Table. In this lesson of Algebra section 1.6, we are going to learn how to solve a quadratic equation using completing the square method. Now, what is completing the square method? Before we go into detail, we need to recall a few things which we have covered in our previous videos, such as in section 1.34, we learned about algebraic identities. What we discussed there was that the right side of each of these identities was called factorized form. Now, these factorized forms also have a second name of completed square forms. This is because the expression on the right side are both written in the form of a perfect square of either the sum or difference of two things. Now, why do we need to study these forms in detail? Let's check another example which we discussed in section 1.4 of the sum product method. What we discussed there was how to factorize a quadratic expression by splitting the midterm into two parts, and by factorizing further, we used to get the final factorized form of such an expression. Now, this method was one of the most common methods of solving quadratic equations. But sometimes we are given equations of a kind in which we cannot apply this factorization method, such as in this equation 2x squared plus 3x minus 31 equal to 0. We can see that we cannot find a method to break this middle term into two parts such that we can get the final factorized form of such an equation. So for such kind of equations, we need to find some other methods. Now, what we discussed in example 1.51 part B was that we were given an equation of such a kind in which the left side was written in a form similar to the completed square form of the identities. Now, in that example, what we did was that we used to take square root on both sides, and we used to get two simple equations in which the constant on the right side was positive in one of the equations, and in the second equation, the same constant was with a negative sign. And we used to solve these two equations separately to get the two different solutions of this equation. Now, this was pretty simple to solve, such kind of equation. An interesting point of this form is that any kind of quadratic equation can be converted into such a kind of completed square form by using and completing the square method. So what we need to do is, in this video, we are going to find out how to convert an equation of this kind into a completed square form similar to this given in the example 1.51. Now let's solve this equation using completing the square method. Now, as always, the first step is to check whether there is a highest common factor among all the terms in the expression on the left side. So here we can see that there is no highest common factor. So we'll directly proceed towards the second step. Now the second step is to compare this expression with the first identity, which we discussed earlier, based on the positive sign of the second term. Now what we can see on the left side of this first identity is that the first and the last terms are both perfect squares. But here in our given expression, we can see very clearly that neither the first nor the last terms are perfect square. So what we should do is, in that case, we should shift this last term onto the right hand side and focus on the first two terms. Now we can also see that the first term contains a coefficient 2, which is also not a perfect square. So in such case, we can simplify this equation further by dividing the entire equation by the same coefficient 2, so that the first term now becomes simply x square. Now, after this, what we can see that this left side can be compared with the first two terms of this identity, which were a square and 2ab. Now, we can easily see one thing, that the first term a square can easily be compared with the first term x square in our expression. So what we can deduce from here is that in our question, a is equal to simply x. So in this next second term, we can compare this 3 over 2x with the second term of the identity 2ab. Now we can see that the second term of the identity 2ab is comprised of three things. One is the number 2, the second is the first number a, and third, the number b. So what we need to do is, now we need to compare this 2ab with the second term of the expression 3 over 2x. Now we can substitute the value of a here, which was x, so that the b can easily be found out by simply dividing 2x on the other side. Now in this way, x cancels out and we can simply get b equal to 3 by 4. So now when we know the value of b, we can simply complete this left-hand side by simply adding the remaining part b square on the left side of our equation. But if we add the value of b square, which in this case is 3 over 4 whole square, we also need to add it on the right-hand side because we need to keep this equation balanced. So doing that, the left-hand side now can be converted into the completed square or factorized form as x plus 3 by 4 whole square, and the right side can also be simplified by combining these two fractions into 257 over 16. Now after we obtain this form, we can apply the same method which we discussed earlier, that we can simply take square root on both sides, in which we can cancel the square sign, and then we can obtain two simple equations, x plus 3 over 4 or simply 0.75 equal to this value of the square root of 257 by 16, which was 4.008, with one with a positive sign and another with the negative sign. So solving these two equations separately, we can finally get the solutions of this equation. So this was how to find the solution of the equation which cannot be found out by simply applying the factorization or sum product method. So I hope this video is helpful for you. So in the end, we would like to thank you very much for your valuable time. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on Instagram and Facebook to contact us directly. Thank you very much and have a nice day.